Welcome back to the video blog. Adam Daniel Mazet is my name. Welcome to Fort Lauderdale on ice, otherwise known as Toronto. I'm out in the snow. I made a promise that I would. In the blustering snow, in the ice, in the sleet, in the rain, this is my backyard. And thanks again for watching. My name is Adam Daniel Mazet, adamdanielmazet.com. So today we're going to talk about something that I was talking about with some friends this weekend, and I thought I would just pass it off to you, and hopefully you could come back to me with some more information about what you think. What do you think about couples in the sense of power relationships in the couple? For example, what about a couple, both parties have pretty extensive careers, they're pretty well accomplished in their lives, they've been working at what they're doing for quite a long time, they've both made a name for themselves in their respective industries, hopefully they work in two different ones, sometimes they work in the same one, but what do you think about that? How do you handle stuff like that? Are you a male that's in a relationship with a woman where the woman's more accomplished than you, perhaps she has more money, perhaps she has more status and prestige? Are you a woman in a relationship with a man who's basically the sole breadwinner and who's doing the traditional relationship whereby the man is the one that's making the major financial decisions in the house and he's the one that's going out while the woman is basically doing the traditional, note my inverted commas, traditional relationship in the house? How do you feel? Do you think it's possible for two people to be equally powerful in the house with two large egos that are always at odds, at loggerheads with each other? Ready to take each other out at the next slightest turn? I'm curious, what do you think about that? Can you handle it? Have you had situations like that? Are you dating right now and going through discussions like that with the respective dating parties that you're talking about? How do you even come up against something like that? Is it different in different cities? Is it different in New York compared to here in Toronto? Is it different in, I don't know, London compared to Johannesburg? Just a question. I want to know what you think and whether you've been in situations like that. And are you comfortable? Do you find it more preferable to have your spouse in a very prestigious, high, elevated position? Or do you not want your spouse to be, I don't know, a little bit more accomplished than you? Frankly speaking, I enjoy conversation. I like stimulating banter. I like ideas. Ideas are flowing across my table all the time. If I'm with somebody that doesn't really have what to say, it's not going to be a good time. It's not going to say I'm not going to like it. It's not going to say that person doesn't have other redeeming qualities that are very worthy of cultivating and being with. But if you really can't get a good vibe on, what's really going to make a relationship like that last? If it blossoms into a full-on marriage, is it really going to last? That's a question that I have for you. Have you been in relationships like that? And what is your opinion? And what do you think? So there you go. Short little video blog today here from snowy Toronto. Ian, I promised I'd show you what it's like in my backyard when it's snowing, into all of my other friends in the Antipodes, south of the equator, that are enjoying hot summer. That includes South America. This is what we're going through at this time of the year, and yes, it apparently is going to be what they call a white Kratzmach. Thank you again for watching. Catch you again tomorrow. They're predicting there's going to be huge, huge dumps. Today, it is approximately 1 in the afternoon here, but there are going to be huge dumps in the largest city in Canada here in Toronto. You'll see what it's going to look like tomorrow. Maybe I'll wear a hat. We'll see. Wishing you the very best of things.